奉主耶稣圣名讲话。
In the holy name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
感觉好像好久没有上台讲道了。
It feels like it has been a long time since I'm up here, delivering a sermon.
我对讲道还是有压力的。
I still feel very stressed up when it comes to delivering sermons.
尤其是讲完道下来，还要慢面对信徒的反应。
Because I have to face the reactions of the members after I deliver my sermons.
啊，有时候是很烦恼的。
And sometimes it can create a lot of trouble.
啊，有时候也真的是很累人的。
And sometimes it can be tiring.
其实大家为主工作，一定都有不同的烦恼，不同的劳累的。
We will have different types of labors as well as our troubles as we labor and work for the Lord.
连最简单的来聚会敬拜神也是有烦恼，有时候你会感觉到很沉闷。
And sometimes we will feel that it is quite a tiring thing even just to come for services, which is the most basic form of worship.
但是你看，一个意外发生，我就只好躺在床上。
But when a mishap had happened to me, I have no choice but to lie in bed.
连你想要为主讲道，为主讲道而烦恼而劳累都不能够。
And you will have no opportunities to worry and to toil and labor for the Lord through sermon speaking.
因此我首先要感谢神，让我还有机会可以继续上台来讲道。
Hence, I'd like to first of all thank the Lord that I'm still given this opportunity to be up here to deliver a sermon.
你们也一样要感谢主啊。
And you also need to thank the Lord.
让你们能够来聚会。
That you're able to be here for service.
让你们也能够为主工作。
That you're able to work for the Lord.
因此，我们也要为那些不能够来聚会或者不愿意为主工作的人来祷告。
And because of this, let's also pray for those who are unable to come for service or are not able to work for the Lord.
不管是因为灵性有病或者是身体有病。
Be it whether they are physically or spiritually ill.
求主怜悯帮助我们大家，让我们大家都能够一同来聚会敬拜神侍奉神。
May the Lord have mercy on all of us that we are able to serve him and to worship him.
有一天你真的会明白的。
One fine day, you will finally understand.
能够平安来聚会敬拜神真的是一个恩典。
To be able to come for services and have this peace, it itself is a grace.
但是我们总是要等到我们失去不能够来聚会的时候，我们才会后悔，才会遗憾。
But frequently we only regret when we have lost this opportunity to come for services.
那不要遗憾和后悔，那就要珍惜我们每一次的聚会，每一次的侍奉。
In order for us not to regret, we must treasure every time we come here for services and each time we work for the Lord.
能够为主烦恼一些，为主劳累一些，这真的是主给你的一个恩典。
To share some worries and troubles as well as to labor for the Lord, this is a grace which the Lord has given to you.
不是吗？
Isn't it the case?
你有主的恩典，你想要为主劳累、为主烦恼都不能够。
Without the grace of the Lord, even if you want to labor and to work and to share these worries of toiling for the Lord, you'll not be able to.
躺在病床上的时候，你只能够东张西望，看天花板，听旁边病人在那边痛苦的声音而已。
Because when you lie on the sick bed, you can't do anything but to stare at the ceiling and to listen to the cries of pain of the patients that surrounds you.
想了很多，但是什么都不能够做的。
You may have thought about many things, but you're unable to do any of them.
好了。我应该要讲道理，不要讲太多感想了。
Okay, I'll go into the sermon now.
我继续来讲启示录的得胜者。
I'd like to talk about the victors in the book of Revelations.
主借着启示录告诉我们去教会所发生的种种问题。
And through the book of Revelations, the Lord tells us the various things that happened to the seven churches.
主没有拿去这一些问题。
And the Lord did not take away all these problems.
主任凭这些问题存在在教会里面。
The Lord allowed these problems to continue to exist and happen in the church.
不是要让我们来去怀疑主的存在。
It is not for us to cast a doubt on His existence.
乃是要我们来去面对这些问题。
But it is for us to be able to face these problems.
主要我们不要成为这些问题的失败者。
The Lord does not want us to be defeated because of these problems.
主要我们成为这些问题的得胜者。
The Lord wants us to be victors of these problems.
我们上一次谈到以弗所教会的问题跟士美拿教会的问题。
We talk about the problems that existed in the church of Ephesus and Smyrna.
那我们现在来谈别加摩教会的问题。
Let's talk about the problems found in the church of Pergamos.
我们请看启示录第二章。
Let's look at Revelation chapter 2.
十四跟十五节。
Verse 14 and verse 15. Revelation chapter 2 verse 14 and 15. But I have a few things against you because you have there those who hold the doctrine of Balaam, who've taught Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols, and to commit sexual immorality. Thus, you also have those who hold the doctrines of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate.
我们看到别加摩教会面对两个问题。
The church in Pergamos faced two problems.
第一个问题。
First,
有人服从了巴兰的教训。
And some held on to the doctrine of Balaam.
主耶稣说
，The Lord Jesus says，
这个巴兰曾教导巴勒将绊脚石放在以色列人面前，叫他们吃祭偶像之物，行奸淫的事。
Balaam taught Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel to eat things sacrificed to idols and commit sexual immorality.
这件事记在民数记二十五章。
And this is recorded in the book of Numbers chapter 25.
我们读第一节到第三节。
Let's take a look at Numbers, the book of Numbers chapter 25 verse 1 to verse 3. Numbers chapter 25 verse 1 to verse 3.Now Israel remained in Acacia Grove, and the people began to commit harlotry with the women of Moab. They invited the people to the sacrifices of their gods, and the people ate and bowed down to their gods. So Israel was joined to Baal of Peor, and the anger of the Lord was aroused against Israel.
第九节
Verse 9. And those who died in the plague,were 24,000.
为什么这些以色列人这么轻易就被诱惑来去敬拜偶像巴利？
Why were the people of Israel easily enticed to worship Baal?
是不是巴利神比耶和华神更有能力？
Is it because Baal was more powerful than the Lord?
他行更多的神迹奇事？
Did he perform more miracles?
他施更多的恩典。
Did he give more grace and blessings?
其实都不是。
The reality is that it is no to all these questions.
是敬拜巴利的仪式那一种吃喝玩乐的吸引力很大。
But it is the attractiveness of the eating and drinking and being merry associated with Baal worship.
那一种玩乐是男女之间的淫乱。
And these joys that they derive is joys that is sexual in nature.
所以摩押的女子就来勾引以色列人。
And because of that, the daughters of Moab started to entice the children of Israel.
你跟我一同敬拜巴利，你就可以跟我一同来玩乐。
If you were to worship Baal together with me, then we are able to to play together.
那以色列人禁不住这一种的诱惑，要跟他们行淫乱，那就先要敬拜他们的偶像。
And the people of Israel were not able to withstand that type of enticement or temptation. And in order for them to play with this with them, they have to first worship this Baal.
不是他们不明白， 道理。
It is not that they do not understand the word of God.
不是他们不知道神的能力，神的恩典很大。
It is not that they do not know that the power and the power of the Lord is great.
但是他们面对引诱的时候，经不起这一种的诱惑。
But when they were faced with all these temptations, they are not able to overcome these temptations.
他们选择放纵肉体的情欲来满足肉体的快乐。
They chose to give in to the lust and to let go of this their desires.
他们甚至说，你可以一样敬拜神啊，但也一样可以敬拜我们的神，跟我们一同玩呢、啊，这些都没有不要紧的。
And they even told the people of Israel, "It's okay, you can worship of God, you can also commit harlotry with us."
以色列人就这样做了。
And that was what the people of Israel did.
这也惹起了神极大的愤怒了。
And this incurred the great wrath of the Lord.
结果死了24,000人。
As a result, 24,000 lives were taken.
所以巴兰的教训就是教导人，你可以一面敬拜神，但是你一面也可以跟巴利联合。
So the teaching of Balaam is such that we can worship the Lord God, at the same time we can also commit a harlotry with the people of Moab.
毕加摩教会有人服了巴兰的教训。
And there are people in the church of Pergamos who are holding on to this teaching of Balaam.
那也就是说他们接受一面敬拜真神，一面可以跟偶像联合的道理。
Which means that they accept the teaching that they can worship the Lord God on one hand, and on the other hand, they worship the idols.
当时他们面对罗马政府的压力。
They were faced with great pressures or stress from the Roman government at that time.
他们必须要向罗马皇帝的像来敬拜。
And they have to bow down before the statue of the Romans.
他们不能够坚持信仰，不拜这些偶像。
They are not able to continue to hold on to their faith and not to worship this idol.
因为他们惧怕这种的迫害，他们不愿意为主受苦。
They were afraid of being persecuted. They were unwilling to suffer persecutions for the Lord.
因此他们就服了巴兰的教训。
And because of that, they submit or they started to accept the doctrine of Balaam.
他们认为敬拜罗马皇帝的像只不过是表达他对罗马政府的忠心而已。
And to them, they felt that when you bow down before the statue of the Romans, you are just respecting them, the rule of the Romans.
而且罗马政府的要求不多。
And the requirements or the requests of the government of Rome is not too many.
你只要有一次在这个罗马皇帝的像面前来烧香，来说凯撒是主。
As long as you just do it once before the statue of the Romans, to offer sacrifices and proclaim that Caesar is the Lord,
那么你就可以回去敬拜你的神了。
Then you can go back to worship your true God.
只要你这样妥协一下，你就解决了这些问题，不是很好吗？
Such a compromise and you can solve a lot of problems, isn't this good?
是的，这个妥协一下让你解决了罗马政府的问题。
Yes, that moment of compromise allows you to solve the problem you have with the Roman government.
但是你怎么样来面对神审判敬拜偶像的罪呢？
But how are you going to face with the judgment of God that you have worshipped idols?
上一次我们谈到斯米纳教会的信徒啊，就是因为他们坚持道理，不去敬拜罗马皇帝的像而为主殉道了。
The last time when we spoke, we said that the believers in Smyrna continue to hold on to their faith. They didn't worship this statue of the Romans, and because of that, they were persecuted.
他们服从主的道，所以他们得到主的称赞。
They rather submit and obey the teachings of the Lord, and because of that, the Lord praised them.
可是贝加摩教会的信徒却在服了巴兰的教训，与偶像联合了。
But the believers in Pergamos decided to hold on to the teachings of Balaam, and they joined with the idols instead.
因此他们被主严厉的责备了。
As a result, they were rebuked by the Lord.
好，今天的教会会有人一面敬拜真神，一面去敬拜偶像吗？
In the church today, will there be people who worship God on one hand and worship idols on the other hand?
你现在不会, 但将来你会吗?
If you are not doing this now, will you do it in the future?
没有威胁, 没有逼迫, 你当然不会, 但是当面对威胁和逼迫的时候,
without any persecutions, without threats, you will not do that. But what if you face with persecutions and threats?
这些问题不能够等到那个时候才来想清楚, 你必须现在想清楚。
You cannot only think of that problem when the problem comes. You must be thinking about that potential problem coming now.
你必须现在下定决心。
And think about it clearly and make a decision.
那你就可以好像但以理的三个朋友一样。
Then you can be like the three friends of Daniel.
你就会对王说,
You will tell the king.
他说王啊, 我们不需要考虑了。
And Lord, King, we do not need to consider anymore.
我们已经考虑清楚了。
Because we have thought about it. Clearly,
我们纵使被丢在火窑里面, 我们也绝对不会拜你的像的。
Even if we were to be thrown down into the fiery furnace, we will not worship your statue.
许多人在信仰上不能够坚持, 就是在那个时候他们还在那边怀疑, 到底要做还是不要做啊, 我们要怎么办来面对啊?
Many people were not able to continue to hold on to the faith because they only consider the problem when they meet with that problem.
你那一种的心在那边摇摆不动, 很容易
And because you are not firm, you can waver left or waver right. The moment when any pressure is exerted on you, you will fall.
但是你已经想清楚了, 你已经下定决心了,
but if you have already thought about it clearly and you have already decided,
我服从主的教训, 我绝对不服从巴兰的教训,
I will only submit to the teachings of the Lord. I will never submit to the teachings of Balaam.
我只敬拜独一真神, 我绝对不敬拜偶像。
I only worship the one true God. I will never worship the idols.
这不是人的教导, 这是主的吩咐。
This is not a teaching of man. This is a commandment of God.
但是很可惜的。
But it is a great pity.
某一个地方的真耶稣教会,
that in a true Jesus church in a certain place,
他们的传道在面书上这样的写,
and their preacher wrote on Facebook,
在出埃及记20章第3节,
in Exodus chapter 20, verse 3,
这里说,
in Exodus chapter 20, verse 3,
除了我以外, 你不可有别的神。
Exodus chapter 20, verse 3 says that apart from me, you have no other gods.
在第5节说,
and verse 5,
不可跪拜那些像, 也不可侍奉他,
you will not bow down to them or serve them.
因为我耶和华你的神是祭邪的神。
For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God.
他说明,
and he explains,
可见的, 在除了我以外, 不可有别的神的先界条件下,
that under the condition that apart from me there's no other God,
神禁止的不是跪拜, 而是不可有别的神。
The God did not forbid bowing down, but God is forbidding having another God.
他再强调,
and he emphasized,
关键不在敬拜, 而是在于你是否将跪拜的对象当作神。
What is critical is not the very action of you bowing down in worship. What is critical or crucial is whether you have treated the person you bow down as your God or not.
然后他再进一步说明,
and he further explained,
在长辈的丧礼中,
in the funeral of someone who is in the older generation who passed away,
那些做子女的或者行礼或者是跪拜的动作里面, 他们毫无将长辈当作神来敬拜的成分。
That when the bereaved family starts to bow down and to kneel before the deceased, they do not treat the deceased as a god.
被禁止无非是教规的枷锁而已，跟圣经无关。
And if you forbid, this is just a teaching of the church. It has nothing to do with the Holy Bible.
这是他的 道理,
and this is what he's teaching.
他公开在面书上发表,
and he expressed this openly on his Facebook.
那我们教会有些信徒去like这种的教训,
and some of our members in our church put a like in his comments on.
但是神不like这种的教训。
But Please be clear that God does not like this type of teaching.
因为这是违背神的教训。
Because this is going against the commandment of God.
神已经很清楚地写下第一条诫命。
God has clearly wrote the first commandment.
除了我以外不可以有别的神。
That I'm the Lord God, and apart from me, there's no other gods before me.
第二条诫命。
Second,
不可跪拜这些像。
And you shall not bow down to any of these idols.
如果神 他真的不是禁止跪拜，而是禁止不可以有别的神。
If God is only forbidding having another God and not forbidding bowing down in worship,
那么神写下第二条诫命，不可以跪拜那一些像，是不是多余的？
Then wouldn't it be extra for the Lord to make the second commandment that you shall not bow down and worship idols?
那么第二条诫命是不是等于不需要的，可以删除掉的？
Does it mean that the second commandment is irrelevant and it can be taken away?
神的诫命写得那么清楚。
The commandment of God is absolutely so clear.
不可跪拜那一些像。
Do not bow down to all to any of these idols.
但是神人还是要来扭曲神的命令。
But men still like to twist the commandment of God.
关键不是在于跪拜，而是在于你是不是把对方当作神。
And they say that what is crucial is not whether you bow down or not. What is crucial is whether you treat the other party, the person that you bow down as God or not.
对那一些跪拜偶像的人，或者跪拜死去父母的人，他们当然很喜欢听到这样的教训。
For those who bow down and anew before the deceased, they will love this type of teachings.
但这种教训不是主的教训，这是巴兰的教训。
But this is not the teaching of the Lord. This is the teaching of Balaam.
他叫你可以一面敬拜神，但是一面去跪拜偶像没有关系的，只要你不把他当作神，你的跪拜不要紧的。
Because it teaches you to worship the true God on one hand, and on the other hand, you can still bow down to the false gods as long as you don't treat them as gods. It's okay.
列加摩教会有人服了巴兰的教训。
There are believers in Pergamos that decided to submit themselves to the teachings of Balaam.
今天真耶稣教会里面也有些传道，有一些信徒，很多信徒也一样服了这种教训，甚至公开的去赖。
And today in the True Jesus Church, there are preachers, there are also many members who had openly liked these type of teachings.
巴兰的教训还有另外一点。
There's another point concerning the teaching of Balaam.
那就是你可以去贪爱钱财。
That is, you can love money.
为了得到钱财。
In order to receive wealth,
你可以去跟世俗妥协的。
You can compromise with the world.
列加摩教会的信徒，他们要做生意。
The believers in Pergamos wants to conduct businesses.
那你免不了就要参加各一种社团的活动。
And it is inevitable then for them to participate in community work.
或者他们商业上的那一种的交际，那一种的聚会。
Or community events, or to participate in business association kind of events.
那么他们这些活动大部分都跟祭拜偶像、跟祭拜偶像之物，甚至跟淫乱有关联。
And these activities are closely related to worshipping of idols, eating food offered to idols, and sexual immorality.
巴兰的教训说。
And the teachings of Balaam says,
我们活在这个世界上,
that we live in this world,
我们需要钱来生活,
we need money to live.
为了得到这个钱财,
to receive this money,
我们跟他们妥协是不要紧的,
it is alright for us to compromise with these things.
你可以跟他们一同的敬拜, 一同的吃喝, 他们所吃喝的,
you can worship with them, you can eat together with them.
其实他们这种是贪爱世界, 放纵肉体的情欲而已。
But these are people who love the world and give into the lusts of the flesh.
基督徒当然可以参加各种的社交活动。
Christians can participate in all sorts of social activities.
当然也可以参加你们各种商业上的应酬。
You can also participate in all these diverse types of business networking.
但是你可以不参加他们那一种祭拜偶像的活动，或者是淫乱的活动。
But you can say no to participating in the activities when it comes to idol worshipping or sexual immorality.
你总要分清楚你的立场，并且站稳你的立场。
Because you have to make a stand and make that stand clear.
有一些东西是可以退一步的妥协的，但是有一些东西是绝对不可以退一步，绝对不可以妥协的。
There are things that you can compromise and take a step back. There are things that you can never compromise. You can never take a step back.
不该妥协的你妥协，该妥协的你不妥协，那就真的是颠倒了。
If things that you ought to compromise, you can compromise. You did not compromise, but things that you should not compromise, you compromise, and you got it opposite.
好，那他们第二个问题是什么呢？
What is the second problem?
有人服从了尼哥拉一党人的教训。
That some had held on to the doctrine of the Nicolaitans.
尼哥拉一党的人是怎么样的人？
What is this Nicolaitans?
有两个解释。
There are two explanations.
按照字的意义来说。
According to, if you look at the word Nicolaitans.
尼哥拉的意思就是高过人民或者是胜过人民。
It refers to those who are above men.
那因此有人认为尼哥拉一党的人就是指那些在教会里面有地位有权势做高位来掌来管治人的人。
And to the people, it could be a Nicolaitans could refer to those who are of high authority, who has some form of positions, and they're higher than the rest of the people in church.
他们在教会里面特别抬高他们的权力和地位。
And they elevate their position and their authority in church.
他们也因此在教会里面造成这一种阶级之分。
And because of that, they create hierarchies in church.
他们甚至用权力来管制，甚至是压迫这些信徒。
They use authority to rule and to oppress the members.
这是违背主的教训。
And this is going against the teaching of the Lord.
在马太福音二十章的二十五节。
And because in Matthew chapter 20 verse 25,
主耶稣说道
，The Lord Jesus says,
外邦人有大权、超权管束他们。
In 20 verse 25, the Lord Jesus says that you know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them.
只是在你们中间不可这样。
But it shall not be the case among yourself.
你们中间谁愿伟大，就必做你们的用人。
Verse 26, whoever desires to be great among you, let him be your servant.
正如人子来，不是要受人的服侍，乃是要服侍人。
Verse 28, just as the Son of Man did not come to serve, to be served, but to serve.
尼哥拉一党的人是主所恨恶的人。
And the Nicolaitans is a group of people whom the Lord hates.
你不要以为拜偶像才是神所恨恶的。
And don't just think that the Lord only hates those who worship idols.
把自己抬高到神台上，叫人家来崇拜，这也是神所恨恶的。
And the Lord hates those who elevate themselves so highly and to cause others to admire, to hero worship this person. God hates this type of people.
所以在启示录第二章的第六节
，In Revelation 2 verse 6，
主耶稣对以弗所教会说
，The Lord said to the church in Ephesus，
你恨恶尼哥拉一党人的行为，这也是我所恨恶的。
You hate the deeds of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate.
我们看到以弗所教会的信徒站在主的那一边。
The believers in Ephesus were on the side of the Lord.
他们恨恶主所恨恶的尼哥拉一党人。
They hated what the Lord also hated, which is the Nicolaitans.
所以得到主的称赞。
And because of that, they were praised by the Lord.
但是你看别加摩教会。
On the other hand, if you take a look at Pergamos Church,
他反而服了尼哥拉一党人的教训。
And they held on to the doctrine of the Nicolaitans.
他们去爱主所恨恶的人。
They went to love those who the Lord hates.
所以被主责备了。
And because of that, they were rebuked by the Lord.
好，另外一个解释。
The other explanation.
按照古代的一个传说
，According to the some old sayings，
尼哥拉一党的人就是主张肉体可以去犯罪的人。
The Nicolaitans is a group of people who held on to this belief that you can sin whatever you want in the physical flesh。
因为肉体犯罪不会害死灵魂的。
Because the sin in the flesh will not cause your soul to die。
反正你用身体去犯罪。你有了犯罪的经验，你就有能力来去胜过这些罪。
On the other hand, if you have the experience of committing sin in the flesh, that experience allow you to know how to overcome sin.
因此，那一些喜欢放纵肉体的人啊，就服了尼哥拉一党人的教训。
And those who like to give in to their fleshly desires, they decide they will they decided to hold on to these teachings of the Nicolaitans.
我不去犯罪, 我怎么知道这个罪, 我怎么有能力来去胜过这个罪?
If I have not committed this sin, how will I know what this sin is all about? Then how will I have the power to overcome the sin?
你说这个是地狱啊?
You say that this is Hades, this is hell.
他回答你,我不入地狱,谁入地狱?
And you say that if I don't go to hell, who will go?
我要怎么去拯救在地狱中的人,我要先下去地狱啊?
How will I save those who are in hell? I must first go into hell.
所以你看这一些人竟然接受这样的道理。
And these people accept this type of teachings.
还以为他们走在正道,其实这是个放纵犯罪之道。
And they thought that they're walking on the right way, but they are walking on the way of sin.
他们认为不要紧,但其实却是害死了他们的灵魂。
They thought that it is alright, but the way they are walking towards, it is the death of the soul.
你看贝加摩教会,真的很多人服从了尼格拉一党人的教训。
Many people in the church in Pergamos held on to the doctrine of the Nicolaitans.
但是相反的,
on the contrary,
你看以弗所教会的人却恨恶尼格拉一党人的行为。
The believers in Ephesus hated the deeds of the Nicolaitans.
所以你看到尼格拉一党人的教训在以弗所教会成不了教训。
And the teachings of the Nicolaitans were not able to be grounded as a teaching in the church of Ephesus.
为什么呢?
Why?
因为这种教训是被恨恶的。
Because these type of teachings are hated.
那一些被迷惑的人,
people who had been disillusioned.
他不知道原来这种教训是被恨恶的, 你说他还敢去跟从这一种的教训吗?
If they discovered that these teachings are being hated, will they still go on to believe in these teachings?
所以以弗所教会保守了那些信徒不去服从尼格拉一党人的教训。
The church in Ephesus preserved the believers in the church, and because of that, the believers did not turn to the teachings of the Nicolaitans.
因为信徒大家都有这一种使命。
Because every believer had this sense of commission.
我们不能够让这一种败坏灵魂、害死灵魂的教训存在在我们的教会里面，教导我们的下一代。
These type of teachings that will cause death to our soul, this type of teachings has no place in our church.
如果只是传道知识讲,有用吗?有这么大的功效吗?
If this is only something that the ministers hold on to, will it be effective?
如果是这样,尼格拉一党人的教训也会成了以弗所教会的教训。
Because if this is the case, then the teachings of Nicolaitans will also find its way into the church of Ephesus.
但是以弗所教会大部分的信徒都恨恶这一种的教训。
But because majority of the believers in Ephesus hate the deeds of the Nicolaitans,
这个力量才是大的,这个力量才能够保守大家的。
And this is a very powerful force, and that force preserve the whole congregation.
相反的,你看别家摩教会。
And on the contrary, if you take a look at the church in Pergamos,
为什么能够成为教会的一个教训呢?
Why did the teachings of Nicolaitans find its foothold to become a teaching in a church?
不是所有的人都服从,有一些人不服从这种教训的。
Not everyone submit to that teaching or accept this teaching, because there's some of them who reject these teachings.
在第十二节告诉我们,
because verse 12 says,
你们当中还有一些人坚守我的名,没有去绝我的道。
And I know those who still hold fast to my name and did not deny my faith.
但是这一些人成不了一种大的影响力。
But this group of people who hold fast to his name are not able to be a force.
他们只能够保守他们自己跟一小部分的人。
And they can only preserve themselves and a small group amongst them.
但是大部分的人还是一样盲目地服从了这个尼格拉一党人的教训。
But majority of the others, which are the others, still decided to turn and submit themselves to the teachings of the Nicolaitans.
所以你看到不但教会的领导者要明白道理,教会的信徒更要明白道理跟坚守这个道理。
And what it tells us is that to understand and to hold on to the teaching, this is something not only the ministers and the leaders have to do, it is something which every believer, every member has to do.
这样就不会给这一些传异端的人有教机会来破坏这个纯正的道理。
If we do that, then people who preach heresies will find no grounding in the church.
所以你有责任要清楚表明你正确的信仰的。
So all you have this responsibility to make a stand on what you believe in.
如果你存心叫人不需要去表明，那其实你就想要浑水摸鱼。
And if you intentionally tell others not to express their stand, then you're just trying to blur the lines.
有些事情啊，真的你要闭一个眼睛，装作不知道就好了。
There are certain things that you have to close an eye and pretend that you do not know.
你不需要去表明立场的。
And there's no need for you to express your stand.
哎，传道，今天煮那个菜哦，够咸的，不用水煮的。
Preacher, today, the vegetables are so salty. I do not know who's the cook.
你不要打抱不平哈，我去探听一下是谁啊？这个会让我们的山高更厉害的呢。
And there's no need for you to respond. Say, okay, let me find out who it is because it is going to cause us to have higher blood pressure.
你是不是没有事情找事情？
Then you are trying to find problems for yourself.
你这种表明立场，这种的勇气有什么用呢？
And if you have this type of courage, what use is it?
是一餐多了一点盐不要紧的。
It's okay if this particular one meal is higher in salt content.
但是在真理上。
But as far as the truth is concerned,
你就必须要勇敢并且坚持。主的真理。
You have to be courageous. You have to hold on and express your stand.
所以主耶稣让我们看到。
Which is why the Lord allows us to see.
同样两个都是主的教会。
Both of these are the churches of the Lord.
但是以弗所教会服从主的教训，但是别加摩教会服了尼格拉一党人的教训。
The believers in Ephesus the believers in Ephesus rejected the teachings of the Nicolaitans.And on the contrary, the believers in Pergamos embraced the teaching of the Nicolaitans.
那主也任凭这两个情况存在。
And the Lord allowed both situations in the two churches to coexist.
让你去面对，让你去怎么样来表现坚持你的信仰。
And it's for you to have the opportunity to face with this problem and to also make a stand.
这是我的考验。
This is my test.
这也是你的考验。
This is also your test.
当主耶稣来的时候
，When the Lord Jesus comes again,
我们在主的审判台前站立得住吗
？Are we able to stand before the judgment seat of the Lord?
所以在十六节主说
，Therefore in verse 16, the Lord says,
启示录第二章十六节
，In Revelation 2 verse 16, repent or else I will come to you quickly and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth.
虽然别加摩教会的信徒服从巴兰的教训，又服从尼格拉一党人的教训。
Although the believers in Pergamos has decided to hold on to the doctrine of Balaam and the teachings of the Nicolaitans.
但是主并没有立刻拒绝他们或者审判他们。
But the Lord did not reject, nor did he judge them immediately.
主耶稣仍然给他们机会，叫他们悔改。
The Lord gave them the opportunity, the chance to repent.
如果不悔改
，But if you do not repent,
那主就很快临到他那里，用口中的剑攻击他们。
Then I will come to you quickly and fight against them with the sword of my mouth.
主口中的剑就是主所讲的道。
The sword of his mouth is the word of God.
主的道是两刃的利剑。
And the word of God is a double-edged sword.
一面是拯救，但是另外一面是审判。
One's edge is to save, and the other is to judge.
你若听从而悔改，这个剑就救你脱离这个罪的捆绑。
If you accept and this sword is going to free you from the bondage of sin.
但是如果你硬心不肯悔改
，On the contrary, if you are hard-hearted and refuse to repent,
这个道就要攻击你，就要来审判你，定你的罪了。
This sword is going to attack you. It's going to judge you of your sin.
十七节
，In verse 17, he who has an ear.Let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To him who overcomes, I will give some of the hidden manna to eat, and I will give him a white stone, and on that stone, a new name written, which no one knows except him who receives it.
那些得胜的
Those who are victors,
表示我们的主期待我们每个人都能够得胜 这一些的问题。
It is an expression of desire of the Lord that he hopes that all of us become overcomers of these problems.
也许你在信仰上有被诱惑被动摇了。
Perhaps you have been tempted, your faith has been shaken.
但是今天仍然有机会让你可以回头跟悔改。
But today is a chance for you to turn back.A chance of repentance.
你必须要胜过这一切。
You must overcome all these.
有很多人不是道理不明白。
Many people, to some people, it's not that they do not understand the word of God.
但是他们没有办法胜过他们的感情。
But they are unable to overcome their feelings and their emotions or relationships with others.
因为巴兰里面有他的爱的人。尼格拉里面也有他所尊敬的人。
Amongst the Nicolaitans, there are people whom they respect. Amongst the people who hold on to the teachings of Balaam, there are people whom they love.
明知道道理不对，但是在感情上还是跟他们合伙。
They know that what they held on to is incorrect, but because they are so emotionally attached, they're still joined with them.
那结果你却被感情害死你，捆绑住你。
And that will become your bondage and will cause a downfall.
有感情是好的，也应该要有感情的。
Yes, we need to have relationships and feelings for one another.
但是感情也有好的跟不好的感情啊。
But there are also good ones and bad ones.
你爱你的妻子是好的感情，是应该的。
You loving your wife is a good relationship, and it is the right thing to do.
但是你去爱别人的妻子，这是犯罪的，这是不应该的，这是破坏人家的家庭的。
On the contrary, if you love the wife of another person, this is itself a sin. It is creating trouble and destroys other people.
同样的道理。
On the same token,
爱主，爱主的道。这是好的，是应该的，救了你的灵魂。
To love the Lord and to love His teaching, this is good and it will save your soul.
但是你却去爱那些违背主道理的，那岂不是害死你自己吗？
But if you love those who have gone apostate, then isn't this going to cause a downfall?
但是到最后还是要你自己做决定，做选择。
But you have to be the one who makes the final decision.
主发出呼声。
The Lord has called out to you.
凡有耳的应当听。
He who has a ear, let him hear.
主也赐下圣灵来感动你。
And the Lord also has given us the Holy Spirit to move us.
但是这个圣灵只能够感动你，不能够强迫你的。
But the Holy Spirit is only going to move you. The Holy Spirit does not coerce you.
也许你听得到，你下了一个决心，也许你被圣灵感动，你下了一个决心。
Perhaps after listening to a sermon or when the Holy Spirit moves you, you make, you decide on a decision.
但是你这个决心要坚持下去啊。
But you have to hold on to that decision.
你不要在这个时候下定决心，踏出教会门口，你的决心就摇动了，就消失了。
And do not let that resolution of yours disappear the moment you step out of church.
下定决心是很容易的。
It is easy to resolve and decide.
但是要一生坚持这个决心到底，这是很不容易的。
But to hold on to that decision and resolution for the rest of your life.
但是你必须成为一个得胜者。
But you have to become a victor.
得胜者就是能够坚持对的到底。
A victor is able to hold on to what is right.All the way to the end.
得胜的主要赐给他云彩的玛拿。
And he who overcomes, the Lord is going to give him the hidden manna.
按照拉比的传说。
According to the tradition of the rabbi.
当巴比伦王尼布贾尼撒来毁灭圣殿的时候，之前。
Before King Nebuchadnezzar came to destroy the holy temple.
耶利米先知就把圣殿里的这个装作玛拿的金冠拿走，去埋藏在山崖里面了。
Prophet Jeremiah took this manna in this urn and then he in this golden urn and he buried it in the mountains.
没有人知道在哪里，它成了一个云彩的玛拿。
Nobody knew where it was, it becomes hidden manna.
但是传说当弥赛亚出现的时候，这个云彩的玛拿也要出现。
And according to tradition, is also saying that when the Messiah appears, this hidden manna is going to appear as well.
所以犹太人脑海中都有一个观念，云彩的玛拿几时出现
？And to the people of the Jewish people, they have this concept, these things in their mind, saying that when is this hidden manna going to appear?
它出现的时候，也就是弥赛亚出现的时候。
When the hidden manna resurface. It is a time when the Messiah comes.
弥赛亚就是耶稣。
The Messiah is Jesus.
他来了。
He has already come.
但是人家认不出他就是那个云彩的玛拿。
But nobody could recognize him as the hidden manna.
但是主耶稣就显明自己。
And the Lord Jesus manifests himself.
耶稣对他们说
Jesus said to them,
你们的祖宗在旷野吃过玛拿结果还是死了
Your forefathers ate manna in the wilderness and they have died.
我就是从天上来的粮
I am the bread from the heaven.
吃我这个粮的就永远不死
And he who eats of this bread will never die.
耶稣公开宣布显明他就是那个云彩的玛拿
Jesus openly proclaimed,That he is that hidden manna.
信他的就必能够得到永生永远的生命
He who believes in him will receive everlasting life.
主耶稣告诉我们
The Lord Jesus tells us.
得胜的我必将那云彩的玛拿赐给他
To him who overcomes, I will give some of this hidden manna.
要赐给他永远的生命
That he will have everlasting life.
而且要赐给他一块白石
And I also give him a white stone.
按照一些学者的解释
According to some Bible scholars
这个白石就是法庭上那一些陪审团他们用来表决用的
And this white stone is used by the jury in the court
白石表示无罪黑石表示有罪
The white stone represents that this person is innocent If a black stone is put forward It is to show that this person is guilty
在使徒行传26章
In the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 26,
第十节
verse 10,
这里保罗说
Paul says,
我在耶路撒冷也曾这样行了，既从祭司长得了权柄，我就把许多圣徒囚在监里，他们被杀，我也触名定案。
That I also did in Jerusalem, and many of the saints I shut up in prison, having received authority from the chief priests, and when they were put to death, I cast my vote against them.
这个触名定案，如果按照原文直接翻译，我也投下了那个石子。
It means that I cast my vote against them, or cast this stone.
这个石子跟我们启示录所读的二章十七节那个石子是同样的字了。
And this vote or this stone is the same as the same word found in Revelations 2 verse 17.
这不是我说的，这是学者说的，我只是跟他说而已。
And this is not what I say, but this is what Bible scholar says.
那我不懂原文，我没不懂得怎么去考证对还是不对，但大概是对吧。
I'm not an expert in the original text, and I think that this sounds reasonable.
因为我去看简单的那些原文的说明，哎，的确是两个都是有写 stone 哦。
Because if you were to look at the root word, both is stone.
好，那主耶稣赐给他白石，就是说，主耶稣宣布他确实是一个得胜者。
And when the Lord gives him this white stone, it means that the Lord pronounced that he is a victor.
你说你是得胜者是没有用的。
Because if you claim that you are victor, it is useless.
别人见证你是个得胜者也是没有用的。
And if you have a witness to say that you are a victor, it is also useless.
也许在看起来你好，表面看起来你是个得胜者，但谁知道你背后说什么？
Because on the surface you may appear to be a victor, but we do not know what you do at the back.
更不知道你心里其实是想什么。
And we do not know what you are thinking in your heart.
但是我们的主知道一切。
But our Lord knows all things.
如果他赐给你一个白石
If he gives you this white stone,
他宣判你真的是一个得胜者
And he pronounced that you are a victor.
这个石头上还写着新名
And on this stone is written a new name.
这个名就是耶稣的名
This new name is the name of Jesus.
因为在启示录14章第一节
Because in Revelation chapter 14 verse 1,
那边记载有14万4千人
It talks about 144,000.
他们的个头上都有羔羊的名和他父的名写在额上
Because they had and these 144,000 having the name of the Father written on their foreheads.
这14万四千人就是那些得胜得救的人。
And 144,000 here refers to those who are saved, who are victors.
羔羊的名和他父的名就是耶稣。
And the name of the Lamb and the name of the Father is Jesus.
因为耶稣的名也就是天父的名。
The name Jesus is also the name of the Heavenly Father.
在约翰福音十七章
This is found in the Gospel of John 17.
十一节
Chapter 17 verse 11.
原文的意思是这么说
And the original text says,
圣父啊，求你借着你的名，就是你所赐给我的名，保守他们。
But these are in the world, I come to you, Holy Father, keep through your name, those whom you have given me, and they may be one as we are one.
好，这个名除了那领受的人，没有人能够认识。
And apart from those who receive this stone, this name is known only to them and no one else.
如果是耶稣这名，为什么没有人能够认识呢？
Why is it that no one else would know the name Jesus?
事实就是这样。
Because this is what happens in reality.
今天许多人都知道耶稣这个人。
Many people today know Jesus.
圣诞节要来了，那些不是基督徒也一样庆祝圣诞节，他们都知道耶稣的生日。
Christmas is round the corner. Even those who are non-Christians celebrate this Christmas, and they think that it is the birthday of Jesus.
所以世上的人都知道耶稣这个人，但是却不认识他其实就是道成肉身来的神。
People of the world know Jesus, but they do not know him as God who came in the flesh.
今天许多基督徒都相信耶稣是道成肉身来的神。
Many Christians believe that Jesus came in the flesh.
但是他们不认识耶稣其实就是天父。
But they do not recognize that Jesus is the Heavenly Father.
也有许多人反对相信耶稣就是天父。
And many people object the belief that Jesus is the Heavenly Father.
如果你说耶稣是天父，那你就是传异端。
If you accept that Jesus is the Heavenly Father, you are preaching heresies.
耶稣是耶稣，圣父是圣父。
Because to them there are two separate entities, the Heavenly Father and Jesus.
就像腓力一样。
Just like Philip.
他真的搞糊涂了。
Philip could not understand.
所以他对主耶稣说。
And he said to Jesus, to the Lord Jesus.
主啊，你把父显给我们看，我们就明白了。
Show us the Father, and we will understand.
那主耶稣怎么说呢？
What did Jesus say?
我跟你们这么久，你还不认识我吗？
I have been with you for so long, do you not know me?
看见我就是看见了天父。
If you see me, you have seen the Heavenly Father.
你叫我怎么样把父显给你看呢？
How am I going to manifest you the Father?
如果耶稣不是天父，
If Jesus is not the Heavenly Father,
他能够讲这句话吗？
Can he say this?
如果他讲这句话，他就是说大话。
And if he say this and he's not, then he's just boasting.
因为明明天父在那一边，你去说我怎么把天父显给你？
Because if this is the case, the Heavenly Father is a different entity, is at that place, and how can he show that? How can he say that? How can I show you the Heavenly Father?
但事实上，耶稣就是天父啊。
But the reality is that Jesus is the Heavenly Father.
所以你叫耶稣怎么把天父显给你？你看见的我就是看见的天父。
And because of that, Jesus says that how can I show you the Heavenly Father?Father, if you see me, you've seen the Heavenly Father.
你叫耶稣怎么把天父显给你看？他已经显给你看了，
how,
只是你不认识他，不相信他了。
How can you ask Jesus to show you the Heavenly Father? He's already done that. The problem is that we do not accept, we do not believe that.
所以这个名字真的除了领受的人，其他的人真的是不认识。你怎么样解释他们还是不认识，不相信？
And because of that, this is a name which only he who received the white stone will understand. The rest will never understand.
但是主没有勉强你。
But the Lord is not going to force it on you.
你可以选择是相信你自己的头脑、你的智慧或者人的教训。
You can choose to believe what you can think of logically, or you can think, or you can choose to believe what the Lord is telling you.
当我们相信主耶稣所说的话，
But we believe the words spoken by the Lord Jesus.
我们就领受主所赐的这个白石。
And then we'll receive this white stone from the Lord.
上面有写着耶稣的名。
And on this stone, this white stone, we've written the name of Jesus.
不但表示我们是得胜的。
It not only express and manifest that we are those who are victors.
主的名更印证我们真的是永远属于主，永远与主同在的。
And because that name is put on the stone, it shows that we belong to the Lord and we will be with him forever.
因此我们必定要成为得胜者。
Therefore, we must become overcomers.
我们请唱赞美诗。
Let's sing hymn
172首。
Let's sing hymn 172.